Assalamualaikum. This is virtual class of Pakistan International School Taif. I am Muhammad Yasin. This English class is for the students of class 5. Today we shall learn to punctuate a paragraph given in exercise 4 of the book. Other than that, we shall learn to correct the order of given sentences given in exercise 5. Moreover, we shall do 2 pages of the workbook, page number 8 and page number 9. Dear students, this is exercise 4. Given in the book. What is written in the instructions? It is written, copy out the passage, putting in all the punctuation and capital letters. We shall write this passage once again by putting the punctuation marks. Let us look at the first sentence. What big pears, the woman said. You can see no punctuation is used here. To do such type of question, we should keep in our mind a few things. First of all sentences begin with a capital letter. We should remember it. The first letter of each sentence is always capital. Second thing, at the end of each sentence, there will be a full stop. If it is a question, there will be a question mark. If there are two things mentioned in the same sentence, there will be and or but. It depends upon the context of the sentence. If there are more than two things, there will be comma. If there is a word expressing a strong feeling, there will be sign of exclamation. If we want to write a phrase or a sentence by using the same words which someone has said, then we shall write that phrase or that sentence in inverted commas. One more thing, if there is a name, first letter of a proper name is always capital. If we follow these things, we can punctuate a paragraph very easily. Let us start. What big pears? As I told you, first letter is W, it will be capital. What big pears? The woman said. After said, there will be full stop. Who said? The woman said. What said? What big pears? This means what big pears are the words of the woman. As I told you, if we write something by using the same words which someone has said, we shall write them in inverted commas. Therefore, before W, inverted commas will begin and inverted commas will close after pears. After pears, we shall write sign of exclamation also, because behind these three words, there is a strong feeling. What big pears? These words are said while being surprised. This surprise is the strong feeling due to which we shall write sign of exclamation after pairs. I think I have told you all punctuation marks in first line. I shall repeat. Before what inverted commas begin, W capital, after pairs, sign of exclamation, inverted commas closed, after said full stop. Come to the next line. Yes, said the man. Again, you can see here, yes is said by the man. This yes will come in inverted commas. After yes, comma, the man said. And they are very juicy. The man is saying more after yes. And they are very juicy will come in inverted commas also. After yes, comma, at the end, full stop. Come to the third line. Please, sentence is starting by writing please. You know very well. P will be capital. After please, comma, may I have one? Please, may I have one? This whole will be an inverted commas. After one, there will be comma. Said Mary, Mary, M will be capital because it is a name. At the end, there will be full stop. I think it is clear now. Now, I shall show you the answer. Let us see. Yes. This is the answer. You can see here what big pairs is written in inverted commas. Sign of exclamation because there is a strong feeling behind it. There's full stop. Yes is written in inverted commas. There is comma after man comma. And they are very juicy is also in inverted commas. Here is full stop. Please, may I have one? This is in inverted commas. This is a question also. That is why here will be question mark. M for Mary will be capital. And at the end, there is a full stop. I think you know now how to do this question. Let us move to the next question. In fact, it is exercise 5. Yes, this is exercise 5. Exactly, it is written like this in your book. Instructions are saying these sentences are in the wrong order. What is the right order? Here we have 4 sentences. They are written in wrong order. We have to change their order. What is this order? Sentences are sentences. They are written A, B, C, D. What is the order? Let us try to understand what is the order of sentences. Dear students, each sentence tells us something, what has happened, or what is happening, or what will happen. Dear students, things happen in a sequence, in an order. For example, if I say, I woke up, washed my face, ate my breakfast, and went to school. I have said the things in a sequence in which I did these things. This is the correct order. If I say, I went to school, I ate my breakfast, I washed my face, and then I woke up, will it be okay? No, this will be a wrong order. The given sentences are also in wrong order. We have to correct the order of these sentences. The method is, first of all, read all given sentences which are in wrong order. These sentences will be 4 or 5. Usually they are 4 or 5. Let us read. Mrs. Ali bought some fruit in a shop. She found that some of the fruit was rotten. The shopkeeper gave her some more fruit. She took it back to the shop. Now we know what is said in each sentence. You can read it once more. To do this question, read the given sentences two times, three times. When you understand very well what is given in each sentence, then you think and try to find out, are these sentences telling us the things in a sequence in which they were happened? For example, we can say, Mrs. Ali bought some fruit in a shop. That is okay. She found that some of the fruit was rotten. That is okay. When she checked at home, she found some fruit was rotten. First she bought, then she found some rotten fruit. After that, the shopkeeper gave her some more fruit. She took it back to the shop. Look here, the order of last two sentences is not looking correct. What should be first? Shopkeeper will give her some more fruit. This will happen first. Or she took it back to the shop will happen first. I think she will go to the shop first. Then the shopkeeper will give her some more fruit. Do you think it should be like this also? Let us try to arrange them. First will be, Mrs. Ali bought some fruit in a shop. Second will be, she found that some of the fruit was rotten. Third will not the shopkeeper gave her some more fruit. Third sentence should be, she took it back to the shop. And the fourth one should be, the shopkeeper gave her some more fruit. I think you understand it very well. Let us look at the answer. Yes, this is the solution. This solution shows sentence number one should be the first one. Sentence number two will be the second one. Sentence number three will be D, the last one, and sentence number four will be C part, the third sentence. This will be the correct order of these sentences. I think you know now, what does it mean when we say write the given sentences in correct order? Order means the sequence in which the incidents have occurred or have happened. We shall write the sentences in the same sequence. The thing which has happened before will be written before. The thing which has happened later will be written later. Dear students, these were the two exercises, 4 and 5, given in our book. Now, as we have finished first lesson of our Active English Book 5, we shall move to the Active English Workbook 5. Let us see what is written in first lesson of the workbook. Oh, yes. This is the first page of the first lesson of workbook. Yes, what is written here? At the top of this page, you can see what is written here. write sentences using while. You will write the sentences at the top, at the left top corner of this page, it is written, write sentences using while. We shall write the sentences by using the word while. First sentence is written for you. Usma was working while Umar was playing. You can see Usma and Umar in the picture. Usma is working. You can write here, reading also. Usma is working while Umar is playing. There will be two parts of this sentence. One will be about one person. The second will be about the other person. And in the middle, there will be the word while. We shall complete all these parts just like the given example. Let us start from part number two. Let us try to find out how we shall complete it. We can see here Usma. Here at the left, there is written Usma and Zeb. This means there are two people here. Two girls are here in this picture. One is Usma and the other is Zeb. Okay, what will be the solution? Yes, Usma is doing something. You can say working or reading. You can see Zeb is sleeping. Oh yes. How shall we complete it now? Usma was, you can write here working, you can write here reading. Because reading is a work also. Usma was reading, and you know very well, in the middle, we write the word while. While will be written in the middle. Now we know Usma was reading while. Let us see what will be there after while. After while, we shall write about Zeb. What is Zeb doing? Oh, Zeb is sleeping. Now we know we shall complete the sentence by writing Usma was reading while Zeb was sleeping. This will be a complete sentence. Let us write this sentence here in number two. Yes, we have written. Usma was working, reading. I have put here a slash in between working and reading. You can write any one of these two words. Usma was working while Zeb was sleeping. We have completed part number two. Let us look at part number three now. First of all, we shall try to find out who are there in picture number three. We can see Usma and Maruf. Yes, now we know who are there in the picture. We know now there are Usma and Maruf. Let us try to find out now what they are doing. Usma, oh yes, look at Usma, look at her face. Is she crying? Yes, she is crying. And look at Maruf. Look at his face. Is he laughing? Yes, he is laughing. Now, first of all, we shall write about Maruf because his name is written. First of all, we shall say Maruf was laughing. Maruf was laughing. and we know in the middle we have to write the word while, because we are said here in the instructions that we have to write the word while. Maruf was laughing while Uzma was crying. This will be our complete sentence. Maruf was laughing while Uzma was crying. This will be our complete sentence. Let us write our answer. Yes, Maruf was laughing while Uzma was crying. We have completed this part also. Let us move to the next part. First of all, you know very well, we try to find out who are there in the picture. We can see, here is written also, the teacher and the children. The teacher and the children. We shall start our answer by writing the children. Now try to find out what are the children doing. Oh yes, they are listening the teacher. What shall we say here? The children are listening. After listening, what shall we write? We shall write while, because we have to write while in the middle. As per instructions of this page, we shall write, the children were listening while the teacher, what is the teacher doing? Teaching. The children were listening while the teacher was teaching. This will be our complete sentence. Now we know how to complete this sentence. Let us write the answer now. Yes, we have written the answer. The children were listening while the teacher was teaching. Come to the next part now. Here, first of all, we shall try to find out who are there in this picture. If we look here, we can see there is Uzma and Umar. Uzma and Umar. We can see Uzma here. Now there is a little change after four sentences. In first four sentences, we wrote the word while in the middle, here and here and here and here. But now in sentence number five, we are set to write the word while in the beginning. No problem. We shall complete this sentence in the same way. The difference will be only that we shall write the word while in the beginning. While Uzma was, what is she doing? She is playing the piano. While Uzma was playing the piano, dear students, one more thing is about which you have to care. What is that? When while is written in the beginning, you will write a comma in the middle. Yes, it will become, while Uzma was playing the piano, comma, Umar was reading the newspaper. Umar was reading the newspaper. Yes, it will complete like this. Now we know. Let us write the answer. We have written it. While Uzma was playing the piano, Umar was reading the newspaper. Let us move to the next. Who are there? We can see there are the boys and the girls. There are the boys and the girls. While the boys, what are the boys doing? They are swimming. While the boys were swimming, comma, the girls were sitting on the beach. Let us complete it. While the boys were swimming, comma, the girls were sitting on the beach. Let us move to the next. Who are there? Mr. Shah and the children. We shall start it by while. While Mr. Shah was driving, the children were sitting in the car. You can say the children were looking out through the window. You can write. Both will be correct. Yes, while Mr. Shah was driving, the children were sitting in the car. You can say, while Mr. Shah was driving the car, the children were sitting in the car. You can say like this also. You can say, while Mr. Shah was driving, the children were looking out through the window. That will be correct also. Let us see what is next. Mrs. Shah and children. Mrs. Shah is doing what? Cooking. While Mrs. Shah was cooking, comma, the children were sitting. The children were sitting at the table. Let us write it. While Mrs. Shah was cooking, the children were sitting at the table. We have done this also. Dear students, we have finished first page of first lesson of workbook. Now we shall move to the next page of first lesson of the workbook. Oh yes, the second page of first lesson looks like this. This is the complete page. Second page of the first lesson in the workbook. So small it looks. I cannot see it very well. I have divided it into two parts. I shall show you both parts one by one. Then we shall try to do it. Yes, this is the first part of that page. Let us start it reading. Dear students, in first part it is written, "Well done," said the teacher. "There has been a big, important improvement, improve, proof, importance in your work." Boys, the best choice can be improvement. There has been a big improvement. What shall we do? We are said to choose the best answer. What is written here? Choose the best answer. How shall we choose? We shall draw a circle around the correct answer. This B is our correct answer. We shall circle this answer. Let us move to the next. Many children voyage, journey, move, wander, travel to school by bus. Boys, many children travel to school by bus will be our correct answer. Let us choose this answer like this. Let us move to the next. Mrs. John was liked by everyone because of his. Mr. John was liked by everyone because of his kind acts. Let us select the correct answer. Kind acts. We have done first part of this page. Let us move to the second part. Second part is here. It starts by part number 4. Several times a day on the radio and on television, an announcer reads the news. The news will be our correct answer. Let us move to the next. They had no money because they had spent. After has, have, had, we always write third form of the verb, that is spent. Spent will be our correct answer. The visitor made a short speech. Our speech will be our correct answer. The headmistress scolded the girls for their bad behavior. Behavior will be our correct answer. Dear students, we have finished the second page of this lesson in workbook also. That was all for today's lesson that we have done. About the homework, you know very well. What you do in your school, in your class, if you don't do it once again at home, you forget it very easily. To memorize it, to keep it in your mind, it is very important to do it once again at home. Yes, you will do all these exercises in your notebook. They are not so many. Only two exercises are there from your book and two pages from your workbook. Yes, I know you don't have, some of you don't have books and workbooks. I can show you the exercises. You can stop the video to see the exercises to do in your notebook. I told you before also, if you want to print it, you can print it by using print screen button. Now I shall show you the exercises. You can see here, these are two exercises, exercise 4 and 5, which we did here today. How you will do in your homework? You will write this whole paragraph by putting proper punctuation marks. How will you do exercise 5? You will write 4 sentences of exercise 5 in correct order, not in given order. You will write in correct order in your notebook. Let us see. This will be the first page of your workbook. You can see it from here. Do it in your notebook as we have done in our today's lesson. This is the first part of your second page. This is the second part of your second page in the workbook. That is all from our today's lesson. See you later in our next lesson. Goodbye.